Hey, I'm Espin Isabella. Nice to meet you. We're happy to assist you with the presentation. Let us know if you need anything, we're here to help. It's our pleasure to serve you. When it comes to software development, analyzing and validating code is a crucial step in the process. This is where disassemblers and decompilers come in handy. Both programs convert binary code into human-readable text to make it easier for software developers to understand and work with. However, there are some key differences between disassemblers and decompilers that set them apart. While they both achieve the same goal, they do it in different ways and with different levels of output. Firstly, a disassembler generates code in a low-level language, while a decompiler generates code in a higher-level programming language. This means that the output of a decompiler is easier to understand for most programmers, as it is closer to the way they think and work. Conversely, the output of a disassembler is more detailed and closer to the actual machine code, which can be useful for certain types of analysis. Secondly, the output of a decompiler is usually much shorter and more manageable than that of a disassembler. This is because a decompiler's output is structured and indented to clearly display the program's logic. Control flow elements such as if statements, loops, and switch statements are labeled with appropriate keywords, making it easy to see the program structure at a glance. In contrast, a disassembler's output is a linear sequence of instructions, which can make it harder to understand the program structure and flow. Another advantage of decompilers is that they convert low-level idioms into high-level notions. This makes the code easier to recognize and work with, as it is written in a familiar language. For example, a decompiler might convert assembly-level idioms into high-level abstractions, making it easier to identify and work with the code. This can save software developers a lot of time and effort, as they don't have to spend as much time decoding the code. Additionally, decompilers are often able to automate certain analysis tasks more effectively than disassemblers. This is because decompilers are able to recognize and replace repetitive patterns with abstract concepts, making it easier to identify remaining patterns. In contrast, a disassembler may struggle to recognize repetitive patterns in binary code, making automation more difficult. Finally, decompilers perform extensive data flow analysis on the input, which can provide valuable insights into the program's behavior. This can help software developers identify potential bugs or security vulnerabilities, as well as optimize the program's performance. In contrast, a disassembler may provide less insight into the program's behavior, as it focuses more on the low-level details of the code. Advantages of disassemblers. Disassemblers are valuable tools for software developers that convert binary code into human-readable text. They provide a more detailed output than decompilers, which can be useful for certain types of analysis, such as reverse engineering or vulnerability assessment. Disassemblers are able to generate a low-level language code that is closer to the actual machine code, which can help developers gain a deeper understanding of how the code works. Additionally, disassemblers are able to recognize repetitive patterns in binary code, making it easier to automate certain analysis tasks. These advantages make disassemblers an important tool in software development and security research. In conclusion, both disassemblers and decompilers are valuable tools for software developers, but they serve different purposes and have different strengths. While disassemblers are useful for low-level analysis and provide more detailed output, decompilers are more user-friendly and easier to work with. They also offer the ability to automate certain analysis tasks more effectively and provide valuable insights into the program's behavior. Ultimately, the choice between a disassembler and a decompiler will depend on the specific needs of the developer and the project at hand. Thanks for watching our presentation. We appreciate your time and hope you found it valuable. If you have any questions, don't hesitate to contact us at info@espincorp.com or visit our website. Have a great day.